today we are going to start with the second chapter of geography from NCERT, that is Inside Our Earth. Before starting this chapter, I want to tell you something about Earth. As we all know, Earth is our homeland or the place on which we all live, because Earth is the only planet where our life is possible. But at the same time, we also call our Earth a dynamic planet. What is the meaning of dynamic? Means changeable, because our Earth has been experiencing so many changes from the very beginning of its formation. Yes, students, have you ever tried to know what lies in the interior of the Earth, or what supports our landmass from the below, or what is our Earth made up of, or what materials do volcanoes throw up as they erupt? So I will tell you all these answers as we go through up this chapter. But first of all, keep one thing in your mind, that our Earth was formed 5 billion years ago. Yes, our Earth was formed 5 billion years ago, and at the time of its formation, our Earth was just like a ball of molten rock. Yes, what is the meaning of molten? Molten means melted or liquid form. But with the passage of time, as this ball begins to cool down, that can you imagine what happened? All the heavier materials sank down and all the lighter materials came to the surface to form the crust. We already know about crust. Crust is a part on which we all live. So this is all about the formation of the Earth. Now come to our next topic, that is structure or the interior of the Earth. Structure of the Earth. Yes. The structure of the Earth is compared to just an onion. See here, I have this onion. I just want to show that, see what it lies inside the onion. There are so many concentric layers that lies one inside the another, and all these layers have the same center. In this way, we can say that our Earth is also made up of many concentric layers. What is the meaning of concentric? The layers that lies one inside the another. So our interior of Earth is made up of many concentric layers. Here I am going to explain one more example to you, that is of an apple. All of you have seen the outer part of Earth, well, as we all know, is called peel or the skin. So this is the first layer of the apple. Then after the peel, there is a soft material that we all eat, and that material is known as the middle layer of an apple. Finally, there is a center that contains the seed, and that layer is known as the innermost layer of an apple. Similarly, just like an apple, our Earth has also 3 main layers, and these layers are number 1, crust, number 2, mantle, number 3, also call it the uppermost layer of the earth. It is made up of rocks, minerals and soil. But it is the thinnest. It is the thinnest of all the three layers here. I am going to make a rough diagram of an earth just to show the different layers of the atmosphere. Suppose this is our earth, this is our crust, this is mantle, and this is our core. So you can see crust is the thinnest of all these three layers, or we can say that it forms only 1% of the total volume of the earth. And here we can also see the outer solid layer of the crust supports the interior of the earth. In this way we can say that it supports life also. Next, our crust is further divided into two main parts. Number one, upper crust. Number two, lower crust. What is upper crust? Upper crust is known as continental crust. Upper crust is known as continental crust. And lower crust is known as oceanic crust. Lower crust is known as oceanic crust. So, the average thickness of continental crust is 3535 kilometer. It means if we want to go from continents to the mantle, then we have to go 35 kilometer deep inside the mantle. So its average thickness is 3500 kilometer, or it is made up of two main minerals, that is called siar. Siar is the combination of first two letters of silicon and alumina. Silicon and alumina. It means our continental crust is made up of these two main minerals, and these two main minerals are called siar. So this is all about the upper crust of the crust. It is called continental crust. Now come to the lower crust, that is called oceanic crust. If oceanic crust means the part of crust that lies below the ocean, if we want to go from the ocean to the mantle, then we have to go 5 km deep inside the mantle. Or we can say that the average thickness of oceanic crust is just 5 km. It is further made up of two main minerals, that is called sima. Sima in means, the word sima is the combination of first two letters of silicon and magnesium. It is the combination of these two main minerals, that is known as silicon and magnesium. So this is all about the first layer of the crust. It is called topmost layer. It is the thinnest of all the three layers. It forms only 1% of the total volume of the earth. It is divided into two main parts, continental crust and the oceanic crust. The average thickness of continental crust is 35 km and oceanic crust is 5 km. Our continental crust is made up of siar and our oceanic crust is made up of sima. So this is about crust. Now come to the second layer, that is known as middle layer. Yes, our second layer of earth is called mantle, or we can say that most of the interior of the earth is covered with mantle. divided into two parts, upper lintel and lower lintel. In the upper lintel, there are all the main minerals, and in the lower lintel, we found molten magma here. Now, come to our third layer, that is called core. So, it is the innermost layer of the earth. Yes, it is the innermost layer of the earth. Its radius is 3500 kilometers, or we can also say it forms 15% of the total volume of the earth. Yes, core, the interior of the core, see, this is core. The interior of the core is extremely hot, and here the temperature increases between 3000 degree Celsius to 6000 degree Celsius. So the interior of the earth, that is core, is extremely hot. Here we can find all the heavier rocks. Core is made up of two main minerals, that is called nitrate. That is called nitrate, or we can also say gneiss. Yes, gneiss is the combination of first two letters of nickel plus ferrous. What is ferrous? Ferrous means iron. So gneiss is the combination of first two letters of nickel and ferrous. It means most of these minerals are found in core. Further, we divide core into two main parts, that is outer core and the second is inner core. Yes, in the outer core we found all the materials in the liquid form, because here temperature is very high. Because of high temperature, all the things are in liquid form. But in the inner core, the temperature is even more higher than that of outer core. But here the things are in the solid form because of high pressure. Yes, things are in solid form because of this high pressure. Here in the core, we can also say the temperature is even more higher than that of a sun. So this is all about core. Yes, core is the third layer, or we can say innermost layer of the earth. Its radius is 3500 kilometer. It forms 15% of the total volume of the earth. It constitutes main two minerals, nickel and ferrous. In short, we can say nine. Core is further divided into two main parts, outer core and inner core. Outer core means all the things are in liquid form. Inner core means all the things are in solid form. So this is all about the interior or the structure of the earth. See, these are the three layers. Hope you all understand it very well. Now come to our next content, that is rocks. Yes, our next content is rocks. What do you mean by rock? Rock is any natural mass of mineral matter that forms the interior of the earth. Or we can say natural mass of mineral matter that makes up the crust of the earth. Rocks can be, the rocks are different from each other. They are different in their color, size, shape, structure, texture, or even hardness, because they are different in the process in which they are formed. So because of its formation, they are different from each other. All the rocks contain both the materials like clay, chalk, mud, etc. So this is all about rocks, natural mass of mineral that makes up the earth's crust. These rocks are made up of minerals. These are made up of minerals. So they do not have any chemical composition or any physical properties. So this is about rocks. Now come to the types of rocks. Yes, come to the types of rocks. There are main three types of rocks. Number one, there is igneous rocks. Igneous rocks. Second is sedimentary rocks. And third is metamorphic rocks. Metamorphic rocks. So these are the three main types of rocks: igneous rocks, sedimentary rocks, and metamorphic rocks. First, I will discuss with you what we mean by igneous rocks. Yes, the word igneous is derived from the Latin word ignis. Yes, this is the Latin word. It means fire. It means fire. And igneous rocks are also called primary rocks. What is the meaning of primary? It means these rocks are the first one to be formed. So they are called primary rocks. And this igneous rocks means the interior of our earth is very hot, and in the interior of the earth there lies molten magma. When this magma comes to the surface in the form of lava, then after coming to the surface it begins to cool down and becomes solid to form igneous rock. In this way, igneous rocks are formed. These rocks are hard and known porous rocks. Yes, these rocks are hard and non-porous rocks. Yes, igneous rocks are further divided into two main parts. Number one, extrusive rocks. Number two, intrusive rocks. Yes. As the word itself suggests, ex means outside the earth, in means inside the earth. So the rocks that are formed outside the earth are known as extrusive rocks, and the rocks which are formed inside the earth are called intrusive rocks. Yes, the earth's formation is just like the formation of an igneous rocks. Means when molten magma comes to the surface in the form of lava, then this lava begins to cool down and become solid to form igneous rocks. So in this way, the rocks that are formed are known as extrusive rocks. For example, basalt rocks. For example, basalt rocks. Our Deccan Plateau is made up of basalt rocks. So this is about extrusive rocks. Now come to intrusive rocks. So these rocks are formed when molten magma cools down deep inside the earth to form intrusive rocks. Yes, so in this way intrusive rocks are formed, and these rocks take long time to cool down, so they have large grains. For example, granite. For example, granite. And these rocks have large, these have large grains, and they have fine grain structure. So this is all about igneous rocks. Igneous means primary rocks because they are the first one to be formed. And these rocks are hard and non-porous rocks. These are divided into two main rocks, extrusive extrusive rocks and intrusive rocks. Extrusive rocks means the rocks which are formed outside the earth. Intrusive means the rocks which are formed inside the earth. Example is basalt. Here example is granite. Now come to our second rock, that is called sedimentary rock, or we can say secondary rocks. The word sedimentary is derived from the Latin word sedimentum. Sedimentum. What is the meaning of sedimentum? To settle down. To settle down. So, when igneous rocks are broken down into small pieces, into small fragments called sediments, due to the action of wind, water, air, then these sediments are transported and deposited to other places. And what happened then? Then the loose sediments are hardened to form sedimentary rocks. These are hardened and compressed to form sedimentary rock. In this way, these rocks are formed from the igneous rocks. So they are called secondary rocks. These rocks are soft and porous in structure. These rocks are soft and porous in their structure. And these rocks also contain fossils. What do you mean by fossils? The remains of dead plants and animals that are being trapped in the layers of these rocks. So they are good source of fossils like coal, petroleum, natural gas, etc. So this is all about sedimentary rocks. Or we can also say Taj Mahal is made up of sedimentary rocks. An example of sedimentary rock is sandstone or limestone. So this is all about sedimentary, means secondary rocks, because they are formed from the other rocks. Sedimentary is taken from the word sedimentum, means settled down, when these small sediments are compressed and hardened to form sedimentary rocks. These rocks are soft and they are good source of fossil fuels, and examples are sandstone and limestone. Come to our third rock, that is called metamorphic rock. It is derived from the Greek word metamorphos. Metamorphos. It means change of form. It means change of form. When igneous and sedimentary rocks are subjected to heat and pressure, then these rocks change their form into metamorphic rocks. And these rocks are formed below the earth due to heat and pressure. So this is called metamorphic rocks. Means when the form of rock is changed into another form is called metamorphic rock. These rocks are very heavier and harder than other rocks. For example, it changes clay into slate. It changes clay into slate, or we can say it changes limestone into marble. So this is all about metamorphic rock. So once again I am repeating for you types of rocks. There are three main types: igneous rocks, sedimentary rocks, metamorphic rock. Igneous rocks means primary rocks. These are secondary rocks and these are the third rock. So this is all about types of rocks. Now come to next topic, that is rock cycle. Now come to our next topic, that is rock cycle. What is rock cycle? It is the process of transformation in which one type of another type, then it is called rock cycle. So the process of transformation in which one rock is changed into another is called rock cycle. Here I am going to make a rough diagram of rock cycle. Suppose this is magma, igneous rocks, then sediments, sedimentary rocks form, sediments form sedimentary rocks, sedimentary rocks get change into metamorphic rocks, and metamorphic rocks were then converted into magma. So this is the rough rock cycle that I have made for you. Suppose first, what is magma? Magma, as we have already read, magma lies inside the earth. It is molten magma. When this molten magma comes to the surface of the earth in the form of lava, then it begins to cool down and become solid to form igneous rocks. So the igneous rocks are formed, but with the passage of time, when igneous rocks are broken down by the action of wind, water, air, etc., into small pieces, and these pieces are called sediments. When loose sediments are compressed and hardened to form sedimentary rocks, when both the igneous and sedimentary rocks come to the pressure of heat, come to the contact of heat and pressure, then they change into metamorphic rocks. Metamorphic rocks are still under the heat and pressure, and they melt into magma. Magma, once again comes to the surface in the form of lava, begins to cool, forms igneous rocks. In this way, the whole cycle goes on, and this is called rock cycle. So this is all about rock cycle, the process of transformation in which one type of rock is changed into another type is known as rock cycle. So this is all about rock cycle. Now there are uses of rocks. Uses of rocks. Rocks are very useful for us, as we already have known. They are used to build roads, buildings, houses, etc. Roads are also used to make tools for grinding and drilling. Some rocks are very fine in their quality, like gemstone is used to make jewelry. Some rocks are used to make jewelry, and what we can say, rocks are made up of minerals. So these minerals are used in industries like iron, magnesium, etc., and they are also used to make medicines, to make fertilizer. So in this field there are so many uses of rocks. So rocks are very useful for us. So this is all about the uses of rocks. At last, there is very small topic that is called minerals. What do you mean by minerals? Minerals means any natural substance that are found naturally on the earth are used to in industries also. So this is all about minerals. So this is all about our today's chapter, Inside Our Earth. First, this is a summary. First, we have read about the formation of Earth. The formation of Earth. We have read number two. After that, we have read about the structure of Earth. Structure of the Earth. Then we have read about rocks. What do you mean by rock? Then